swastiastu, namo buddhaya, salam kebajikan, and good morning to all of you. Peace be upon you. Welcome to the second day of Extension Events, an extraordinary English competition 2020 with a theme, Beauty of Indonesia Diversity. Organized by Events Management Class, English Program of Vocational College, Universitas Gajah Mada Students, that is lectured by Miss Andri Handayani, and also with me, Amelia Golda, who will be your host for this session, especially for the essay competition category session. All right, everyone, first of all, let's thank to God, the Almighty who giving us the mercy and blessing until we can attain in this session without any obstacles and also in this happy place and time. Everyone, please pray based on your own religions. Pray, begin. Praise enough. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, before we move on, allow me to introduce our judges for this essay competition. So we have Miss Johanna. Hello, good morning, Miss Johanna.
Hello, good morning, Amel. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Miss. Okay, so Miss Johanna is the head of Diploma 3 English Program of Vocational College, Universitas Gajah Mada. Then we have other special judges. They are the lecturer of English Study Program in Vocational College, Universitas Gajah Mada. Hello, Miss Alvelia and Miss Inung. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Good morning, Amel.
Good morning, Amel.
Hello, Miss Inung and Miss Alvelia.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Okay, so everyone, before we come to the main session, I would like to tell you about the host rules beforehand. So the first rule is participants or finalists are requested to turn on the camera and microphone during the presentation. Second, participants will be given 10 minutes to present the material and also 5 minutes to discuss with the judges on the Q&A session. And last is be respectful each other. Okay, everyone, without any further ado, we are going to the next session, that is presentation from the finalists of essay competition. So there are 8 finalists for the essay competition. Okay, so for the first group presentation is from SMA Negeri 2 Yogyakarta with the title The Real Education Never Based on Someone's Background, So What Have They Done This Time? Okay, so for SMA Negeri 2 Yogyakarta, are you here?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So for your groups, time is yours. Thank you.
Good morning, judges, pals, everyone who joined this meeting, and also people who come to class. So today, we are going to present about the beauty of Indonesia diversity. The title of this presentation is The Real Education Never Based on Someone's Background, So What Have They Done This Time? First, let me introduce myself. My name is Alia Maisawa Azahra, and this is my partners.
My name is Ivani Alia Wijaya.
Hello guys, my name is Ferry Sawiritanaya, and we are from SMA Negeri 2 Yogyakarta.
This presentation contains introduction, theory and discussion, conclusion, and also bibliography.
Next.
Indonesia is a country that known as its diversity. Even though they come from different backgrounds, they're still united. That's why the government having a trouble with controlling equalization, especially education. Next. This time, the quality of Indonesia education is far from enough. That's the reason why people think that education isn't important. There is no approximately age or social background restriction. Everyone has right to learn. Problem formulation. Why unlucky people rarely go to school? What effort does unlucky people do?
Next.
What does unlucky people get from surroundings? And what impact does unlucky people get from surroundings? Purpose of the paper. Knowing the reason why unlucky people rarely go to school, knowing what unlucky people do so they can go to school, knowing what reaction unlucky people get from surroundings, and also knowing what impact that unlucky people get from surroundings. Next.
Next. Chapter 2, Theory and Discussion. Next. People may change their mind if education can only be followed by upper classes. In fact, lower classes can be more enthusiastic. They're just struggling with their economic problem. Next. Common people may be the most stupid and honest at the same time to know and judge how the government works. Next. Sometimes there are circumstances that things don't go like in their way, like their children already at school, but they can't pay the rest at administration. So their children need to be dropped out. A careless parent, if their children have a decision, they never agree and told them to stay in their plan. They also can receive their children at fence because they're afraid if their children will mess up everything. This typical of parents will not struggling for their children. They'll end up doing nothing. Plus, an instant parents will do anything for their children as long it does not take a long time process. Next. Now, we're moving to children's problem. It's just a waste if parents are supportive, but their children doesn't effort to catch their dreams. There are a few factors. They're too lazy, confused, and think that education isn't important. Nowadays, the children choose to help their parents instead of studying. Next.
Effort and struggle. There are a lot of effort that unlucky people do, so they make their children go to school. For example, like they work harder so they can choose school their children, but also can fix their life for a better future. Instead of working, they choose to borrow money from people who can lend them, they choose to charge to work. And the last, they left their children to a wealthy family. Next.
Next. Reaction from slide 15. A surrounding reaction between the upper and lower class are different. The upper class mostly have a lot of respect, while the lower class doesn't. Teacher give much attention to upper class because they're sure that the upper class are smarter. But how about their attitude? This time, a major of upper class think that they're more special than others. So why should they respect others? Next. Section slide 16. Mostly the upper class go to school just for formality or society needed, but well, not all of them. There is a children from wealthy family that's smart and respectful. They go to school to gain knowledge and never care about kids. And for unlucky people, teachers saw them in one side, but sometimes their attitude is better. They thirsty for education. They keep going to catch their dream no matter what others say. Next. Impact from surrounding. Lower class always being mocked by others. It's okay if they have a strong mental, but what if their mental is brittle? It can cause depression or suicide. Next. Chapter 3, Conclusion. Next. So the conclusion is education that people got still far from enough. Indonesia still cannot fix their education. It will be great and meaningful if they fix the education system first. Every children has their right to get education. The right education is an education that can be understand enough for the industry and government. Next. So this slide is suggestion. First, education is important and everyone has the right. And unlucky people should not be discouraged when go to school for learning. Teachers should put same attention between two sides. And Indonesia should change their education system first in order to compete with other countries. And then forcing children to master all subjects is wrong. And the last one, children should know what will they learn and what will they be someday. Next.
For the presentation, research from Extension 2020 Essay Competition Quite Look, Tempo 2020, alasan mengapa menutup sekolah sebenarnya bisa berbahaya saat wabah corona. And the last one, Tribun Jateng 2020, kisah guru di Karanganyar datangi rumah-rumah siswa untuk mengajar selama pandemi corona. Next. The one at the left side is a lucky people who can go to school easier, while on the right side is unlucky people who hard to gain education. Next.
So that's all for our presentation today. We hope this presentation can expand our knowledge and also always be a reminder to treat people fairly and always be kind to others. Thank you for your attention. Is there any question?
Alright, thank you so much for SMA Negeri 2 Yogyakarta's group. Next is the Q&A session with the judges. Maybe who wants to give the comments or ask the question to the SMA Negeri 2 Yogyakarta, 2 Yogyakarta's group?
Okay, Amel, so maybe I can ask first. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so thank you. The group from SMA Negeri 2 Yogyakarta for the presentation. So I have to clarify something here. You said that mostly the upper class get a lot of respect, right? Okay.
Yes.
On contrary, the lower class don't get a lot of care or attention.
Yes.
So my question is, does this phenomenon also happen at your school?
Yes, it happens sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Could you please give me the real example of the difference respect given to the poor and to the lower class or to the upper class?
Oh, okay, so I have a friend. She is very...
The example is, I have friends, she's from upper classes and she is very clever, but my teacher give her more attention but that's not fair to another student and my class.
For in my opinion, teachers should treat her or his students fairly. Not just the upper classes, but the lower classes have to treat them fairly.
Okay, thank you. Anyway, that is your suggestion for your teacher, right? What about for you yourself? I mean you and your friend. So what you can do to give respect equally, yeah, to the lower and to the higher classmates, so that the lower class will not feel like, what is it, humiliated atau direndahkan. So what you as the fellow students can do?
Okay, so for me, I never felt sorry for being friends with the lower class.
Mm-hmm.
So I tried to mempengaruhi my friends,
mm-hmm,
to have a mindset that all people is same and we cannot membedakan mereka.
Okay, thank you. I think that's all from me. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Thank you,
yes,
for the answer.
You're welcome.
Thank you, Miss Johanna.
Mm-hmm.
Miss Inu or Miss Alvin, maybe want to give comments?
Right, perhaps I have one quick question. Yeah, not the quick, well, anyway. So actually, I also, what is that? 1 minute left. So you guys, can you give us any example on how perhaps the teacher already, what is it, asked the students to, what is it, participate, so when in class they don't really, what is it, invite the students to participate yet, to get to know the students, but it's the student itself which who doesn't really want to show themselves. So what do you think about that? So usually, yeah, because they kind of feel that they are below the others. That's why they don't have the enough self-confidence to show themselves. Do you have any suggestion for both the teacher and the students, perhaps?
First group, you have 1 minute left. Thank you.
For me, we have to treat others fairly. So maybe trying to communicate with the teacher that everyone is the same. So there's nothing to be afraid of, whether he or she from lower classes or upper classes. We should respect others, and attitude is better. I mean, smarter is not always better. With attitude is much better. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much for the first group and also our judges for giving the comments and asking the question to the first group. Okay, we are going to the next group. That is from SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar, with the title Yamko Rambe Yamko. For SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar, are you here?
Yes, we are here.
Okay, the time is yours. Thank you.
Okay, so good morning, guys. Today we are going to present you our
guys
with the title Yamko Rambe Yamko. But before that, we are going to introduce ourselves. Next. My name is Madi Indira Vidya Savitri, but you can call me Indi.
My name is Koming Cendana Sutrisna Sari, but you can call me Cendana.
And my name is Made Rona Marni Syaja, and you can call me Rona.
And we are all from SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar. Now we are going to start the presentation with Cendana. Next.
So why is the title Yamko Rambe Yamko? Yamko Rambe Yamko is a Papuan song about heroism and war against colonialism in the Dutch era. which is ironic in today's age because instead of being enslaved by the Dutch or the Japanese, Papua is in a way colonized by its own nation, Indonesia. But of course, it might not be the same way as when we were enslaved by the Dutch, but Papuans are getting treated badly by their fellow Indonesian. It's as if that they are not a part of Indonesia. Speaking about Indonesia, Indonesia is known for the world's largest archipelago country and one of the most culture diverse country in the world. That is why we have culture, religion, and race differences that I believe all of us Indonesians are supposed to be proud of. But despite being its greatest strength, differences have been one of the main sources of problem in Indonesia. Next.
In 2020, the topic of racism has peaked in Indonesia, and it is due to, next, the murder of George Floyd, an innocent Black man in America. This incident triggered the world and has revitalized the Black Lives Movement not only in USA, but also in several countries. This act of solidarity has helped highlight the lingering grievances felt by the Papuans who experience a lot of human rights violations, including racism, and thus it sparked the Papuan Lives Matter movement. Next. The most recent case of racism that brought awareness to Papuan Lives Matter is an incident in Surabaya. Next. 43...
Go back. Can you go back, please?
Go back.
One more time?
Yeah. 43 Papuan college students were persecuted by the army, police, and reactionary mass organizations because they allegedly ruined the Indonesian flag by dumping it into the Papuan dormitory sewers. During the siege, they were being cursed at with racism and shouted at with the word monkey. The dormitory was then shot at with tear gas a bunch of times before they were held at the Indonesian Metropolitan Police. However, it turns out that the police did not find any evidence nor the person who ruined the flag. This incident triggered a demonstration in every city and regency in Papua. They demand to sue this act of racism. But instead, what the government did was silencing their voices by blocking their internet access. The perpetrators were then sentenced to prison for 5 until 7 months, but the army who were involved, the punishment is unclear until now. Next.
So, what caused racism in Indonesia in the first place? Racism in Indonesia has been happening in the form of slavery and community grouping based on skin color, race, and ancestry. The Netherlands made social stratifications in its colonies, and in Indonesia, the stratification was divided into three, which are the European group, the foreign Eastern group, which at that time was dominated by the Chinese and Arab, as well as the indigenous group. This stratification could be seen as the root of why modern Indonesia is so used to grouping people based on their differences. Next. So, we are entering a new phase of awareness rising among Indonesians about what is happening in Papua. People in Papua are facing two types of discriminations, which are direct discrimination and indirect discrimination. Direct discrimination, such as mocking in front of their faces, calling them names like monkey. And indirect discrimination, specifically the struggle to find decent jobs or housings just because of toxic stereotypes that still exist in this society. For example, most Papuan college students that are studying in Jakarta are living together, and they wouldn't allow to live in most apartments because they are not allowed even when they're vacant. Next.
So what's making the situation worse?
Next.
The first one is discrimination and the lack of attention given to this problem. Next. The second one is beauty standards. Since Indonesia got their beauty standard influenced by Western countries, brighter complexion seen as the one fulfilling the standard. Papuans are naturally have a darker complexion, which does not fulfill our society's constructed beauty. That is why Papuans are always seen as the bad example of Indonesian's beauty standard. And the third one is underestimation. Indonesia doesn't treat Papua the same way it treats other provinces, where in contrary, Papua has been contributing so much to this country, such as giving profits from gold mines or being the largest producers of palm oil. Most of the people that are enjoying the prosperities of Papua's land are foreign investors, and the locals are not getting the bit of advantages that they deserve to build up their own economy. There are only a handful of rich Indonesians that... are still living in deprivation and lack of education. Next.
It has been a known issue that Papua has been wanting to manage their own country, but situation have been getting worse lately because there is a distrust between the government force or the OPM or Organisasi Papua Merdeka. The government send more army because it is said that the OPM tends to kill its citizens, but according to OPM, they only kill people who are seen as government spies. This topic is still very controversial because there is a lack of news outlet that provides a neutral point of view of the situation. Next.
We see Indonesia as a democracy country, but the law does not match with what a democracy country should have. The definition of democracy is justice for all. However, people seem to treat Papuans as if the law of human rights does not apply to them. Next. As we all know, Indonesia has a national motto, Bhinneka Tunggal Ika, or Unity in Diversity. This does not match up with what is currently happening in our country. The motto does not mean anything if the people in Papua still feel oppressed. If someone from Papua is voicing their opinion, they are presumed to be a separatist, even though they are actually fighting for Papua's human rights. So, do we blame them for wanting to leave Indonesia and build their own country, while we do not want to offend them when they're being oppressed? Next.
So in conclusion is next, we have to be more aware of the current situation. We should not depend solely on the government for this racism act to end. We as a society should intervene in our own way. How? By realizing the current situation in our mirror circle and by educating ourselves to be more aware of the things that are offensive. And secondly, is to be brave enough to point out any racist encounters. And thirdly, as for the government, they should do more socialization programs because there are still people that does not realize that there are actions that can lead to racism. And of course, social welfare advocacy is also needed, especially if the case of racism and discriminations are already at the stage of oppressions and deprivations of human rights. Next. In the end of the day, we as a country should unite regardless our race, religions, cultures, and because
there is only one race, human race.
Next. Thank you for your guys' attention. Is there any questions?
All right. Thank you so much for SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar Group. Next is the Q&A session with our judges. Maybe Miss Inung wants to go first.
Yes, I have a question for group 2, yeah, with the essay entitled Yamku Rambu Yamku. I want to ask, so you are criticizing most Indonesian, yeah, not treating the Papuan equally. But I want to ask you, do the Papuans also socialize well with the other Indonesians, in your opinion? Because I'm pretty sure know that some Papuans who study in several city in Indonesia, they usually live together with their own group, like with the Papuan. They do not, you know, like mingle together with the other peoples. So what do you think about that? Hello?
Yes.
Can you hear me clearly? Can you hear the question clearly?
The Papuan people that are...
Maybe the second...
I think they have connection problem, yeah.
Yes, I think, Miss.
Okay.
For the second group,
Indira, I think yeah, you have connection problem or you can answer it now. I think I can hear you now, Indira. Can you answer my question? Oh, putus-putus ya.
Hello?
Yes, yes. Okay, committee, how do you handle the situation here?
Okay, so the second group, can you hear us?
Yes, yes, we can hear you clearly.
Yes, okay. So,
If you cannot turn on your camera, maybe you can just, you know, answer the questions with your microphone,
you
please.
I think camera.
You, yeah, you, I think you have connection problem.
Okay. So, can you hear us for the second group? Maybe they have connection issue, yeah? Okay. Okay. So, okay, maybe for the second group, the Q&A session will be going after the next group. So we are going to the next group beforehand. Okay, so I will go into the third group from SMA Negeri 1 Jakarta. Okay, so with the title Human Rights and Equality for Indonesia in Education Field During Pandemic. So SMA Negeri 1 Jakarta, are you here?
Yes, we're here.
Okay, the time is yours. Thank you.
We all agree that this year, this pandemic here has brought us to be more human. As human beings, we build sympathy to each other and that makes us feel connected. We also realize that this pandemic has recovered us its various impacts. There are health conditions, economic sectors, education fields, and another aspects in our life. My name is Susana Kaviva.
And my name is Aurelia, and we're going to prove it to you
how this pandemic affects in human rights and equality for Indonesia in education field. Next. Human lives will always experience development, change, reputations, and continuity. These are explained in the concepts of change and continuity in history. Human life is always changing and developing. According to Heraclitus, with his term Pantare, nothing in this universe is constant or permanent. This, our life is always changed and hit happening right now. These pandemics can be some kinds as reputations. Starting when it first appeared in 118-120, the flu pandemic caused by influenza was shook the world because it was infecting more than short populations and ending the lives of 20 till 50 million people in the world. And now, COVID-19 infectious disease caused by SARS-CoV-2 led us to the COVID-19 pandemics that occurred in Indonesia from March 2020 until now. Next. During the last 9 months of our lives, we've been affected by these pandemics. This pandemic requires us their impacts. There are positive impacts and there are negative impacts. The first positive impact is we become more attentive toward our health. We gain awareness of the importance of the maintaining health. And yeah, growing a sense of sympathy and empathy in humans. And finally, people united to help each other in the light of and regardless of their background, ethnicity, race, or beliefs. And yeah, from environment perspective, it reduced air pollution and many countries united and making a collaborations to beat the virus. However, it is contained the negative impacts are even more. There are caused question human rights, violations, and exacerbated social inequality. many people lose their job. Disruptions of school, universities, and vocational education segments, global economic recessions, and increase of poverty level in society, disruptions in the productions of primary and secondary items in society. Next. Education is one of the sectors that have been affected by this pandemic. The COVID-19 pandemic affected educational systems worldwide, leading to closure of schools, universities, and colleges. Next. The closure of schools has caused us another impacts. There are positive impacts and there are negative impacts. The first positive impact is advancement of technology and virtual learning has greatly improved, like what we're doing right now. And the emergence of students' creativity and learning has improved. The emergence of variety of the media and learning process has increased too. But also there are the negative impacts, right? The increase of inequality rate in the education sectors, their learning process become less effective than before. Students frequently study the fewer topic or less constant through distance learning, and student learning environment is not supportive or poor learning environment. We know that Indonesia is We know that Indonesia is a diverse country. It consists of various islands, multiple language, various ethnic groups, and with the diversity, the human rights violations will be easier to occur. Human rights violations cause also the unequal facilities and opportunity for each individual. Human rights guarantee all the human beings have the same values and have the same opportunity. But however, this seems fading away because the threat of the pandemics. And yeah, Indonesia has created the inequality increase. Next.
Okay, can you see the difference here? There are two types of students, students who come from privileged family, which you can see on the left, and student that comes from disadvantaged family, which you can see on the right of your screen. And as Rizzi already said, with the pandemic that happened right now, the rate of education inequality is getting higher. This happened because we are all implemented the study from home activity. And in this activity, we need to provide everything by ourselves because the school are not providing us anything. So it takes a lot more money and it takes a lot more effort to gain knowledge. However, people from disadvantaged family can provide yourself with the things that they need because they are not supported by a lot of things. And this is why the inequality happens. Next, please. And these are the aspects that cause inequality in education system during pandemic. First, limited access to the internet. Second, educational facilities. And third, inequality in the construction of electrical facilities. Fourth, the quality of teacher, because the quality of teacher is different from teacher in big cities and teacher in private schools. Fifth, learning environment, because the learning environment is not supportive, and the last is digital devices. Next. These are some facts, some survey that has been done. First, on August 21st, the ICS USHOP ISHOP Institute released a survey of inequality in education during the pandemic. No, the previous slide, the on fact slide. The next slide, from this research we got information that only 40% of Indonesians have internet access. The result of the survey stated that nearly 69 million students lost access to education. This difficulty in accessing the internet then becomes one of the obstacles of remote learning activities. Second, by using the multidimensional energy poverty index method for districts and cities, states that rural area in Indonesia have a large inequality of electricity use between household groups when compared to electricity consumption in cities. Electricity in rural area is a luxury. It's hard for them to get it because the lack of electrical infrastructure, and it's also hard for them to pay for it, especially now because a lot of people are being jobless. Meanwhile, electricity is very important for studying. It's related to learning hours and the quality of children's learning. Not only for students, the inequality of facilities is also
felt by the teaching staff. The Smeru Research Institute conducted a survey showing that such educational facilities are only owned by teachers from big cities, especially in Java. Meanwhile, teachers in villages need to go to their students' home to teach. Yeah. The quality of teacher is also a problem. According to the data released by the government, Indonesia has more than 3 million primary and secondary school teachers, but more than half of them are not certified as teacher. As you guys can see, this is not fair at all. People from big cities, especially for those who come from privileged family, can easily access all the learning platforms, while students from rural area and students from disadvantaged family needs to struggle a lot. This imbalance is, of course, contributing to the 1945 Constitution, Article 31, Paragraph 1, which reads, every citizen has the right to education, and Article 31, Paragraph 2, that reads, every citizen is obliged to attend basic education, and the government is obliged to finance it. To the next slide, please. The next slide. Yeah, actually, we have some idea to solve this problem. First is fulfilling the teacher's needs. Second is improving the teacher's quality. Third is equitable distribution of infrastructure and development. Fourth is distributing educational support such as internet data, digital devices, and any other support tools, and improving the internet quality and also improving the curriculum of education quality. Next. So in conclusion, there is an inequality in our education system, and this inequality is getting worse during this pandemic. We need to be aware of it because a lot of our fellow students is struggling out there just to gain knowledge. This happened because they are not supported by a lot of things, such as good learning environment, family finance, and a lot of other things. Of course, this violates human rights because every human being should have equal opportunities, but this doesn't happen to them. This is a serious matter, but it's hard for us to help them, and it's also hard for the government to help them because the government has a lot more other things to be settled. But I believe if we gather as one, there's nothing impossible. That, ladies and gentlemen, was what we wanted to share with you. Thank you so much for your attention. Is there any question?
All right. Thank you so much for the third group. Now it's the Q&A session with our judges. Maybe who wants to give the comments or ask the question to the third group?
Okay, may I, Amil?
Yeah, okay.
All right. First of all, thank you very much for the third group delivering such a great topic and for their presentation. Yeah. Well, yeah, I kind of agree. We got that very steep inequality. Yeah, especially for education. I mean, the education for our students here in the and there in rural areas. But yeah, I ever got this term also from a professor from ITB who was expert in education technology. So he said that what we are doing today is not really an online learning during this pandemic, but it's more on emergency remote learning, because in online learning, everyone is ready, the system is ready, the teachers are ready, the schoolers are ready, the students are ready, everything is ready, but now everyone is not ready. So yeah, you guys already mentioned several suggestions like teachers' quality, and then teachers' need, and distributing those
supporting tools.
Yeah, and the curriculum also. But it's kind of it's a long duration to Do you have any suggestion, particular suggestion, or something like more easier to do, faster to do, possible things that we can do all for this in this system? Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna answer it. So I think that for now it's only gonna help a little, but I think to make an organization that consists of student and to study together just around the neighborhood association, it would really help. And to like the government to make like an application that you could access offline, it would really help. And so the government doesn't need to give us the data, the data systems,
internet data,
Yeah. So they could save the money to like make the internet facility on rural area or like electricity facility. And also like the data is, I'm having a Wi-Fi in my home and I'm having, and I get the data assistance policy. Yeah. So I think it should be the data should be, what is it?
Disruption, like the, it changes to the another, it changes to the another.
I think that I shouldn't get the data, but I get the data. I think that it's a waste of money. They should save it on making like infrastructure in rural area instead. Yeah, I think that, I think, yeah. Making an organization in like neighborhood association, I think it would really help. And making an application that you could access offline. It's like CMAQ, you know, the CMAQ application that you'd be used to have, but it's offline. You could access it offline. Yeah. Yeah.
That's our answer.
All right. Thank you so much for the third group answer and also Ms. Alfe for the question. Maybe Ms. Johanna.
Okay. So thank you, Amel. So I really appreciate that group from SMA Negeri 1 Jakarta already present a very comprehensive paper today. Okay, so I have a very simple question. Actually, this is a kind of reflective question for you too. Yeah, so I believe you've already experienced or you have already got a good, we can say that better education like the other students outside Jakarta or outside Java already got so far. So my question is, what have you done as a form of gratitude for the good education that you already have?
Can you please?
Okay, what you have done so far as a form or as a kind of gratitude for the good education that you have?
Okay, I usually have this I make a note and I share it on Twitter, like that kind of thing, like, because like there's a lot of people that couldn't access learning platforms such as Ruang Guru, Zenius, and a lot of other things. And there's also like to access YouTube because it takes a lot of data. So I make notes and I share it on Twitter or like share it on a group chat such as like in on WhatsApp, but it consists like people from all over the Indonesia. There's people from Sumatra, there's people in from Sulawesi, and I share my notes there. To like share the knowledge that I have.
Oh, great. So you kind of sharing your call it ringkasan in bahasa Indonesia, for the lesson that you have learned.
Summary, summary.
Yeah. Okay. What about you, Risti? Yeah.
Well, I used to do that. I mean, I have my account Twitter. It's like study account. And I get the summary too. And I share with them. Well, the other things that we do is we do like Zoom meetings and we are studying together. We're doing this Zoom things and we're just studying together as what we'll talk and
sometimes you're also teaching them, right?
Things group, but all over Indonesia.
Very good. So it's a kind of peer tutoring, something like that. Yeah, sharing your knowledge that you have. I think that will be influential. Yeah. So you can have more follower. I mean, group members that you can study together. Yeah. So it is a kind of good movement, I think.
All right.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay, so thank you. Inspiring.
For your questions.
Okay, thank you so much for our challenges and the third group presentation. Due to the connection issue happened before, we are going back to the second group for the Q&A session. So for SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar, are you here?
Yes, we are here.
Okay, maybe Ms. Inung can repeat the question first. Thank you.
Okay. To appreciate your presentation first, yeah, ladies, because you've done a great job in creating your slides and also your presentation. But I want to ask you that you put lots of criticism to most Indonesian, yeah, criticizing how we treat the Papuans. But I want your opinion about their socialization. I mean, lots of Papuans are studying in other cities in Indonesia, but they usually live in groups. You know, they stay or they live in a boarding house where there are also Papuans. They do not mingle with the other Indonesian, I mean, coming from different cities. So what do you think about that, and how can you invite them to, you know, like socialize, in your opinion?
Okay, so I've read, thank you for your question. I will try my best to answer it. So I've read this article on the internet that said that there is this Papuan college student that are going to study in Jakarta. And then when she wants to live in an apartment, the apartment owner said some racist things, like he or she said that, "No, you're smelly, you're stinky, and you're Papuan, so you can't live here," she said like that. So I think the Papuan college student also really wanted to try and socialize, because they the proof is they try to go to Jakarta to learn and to try and socialize, but the some people there don't accept them for being who they are. So I think that's why they are living in groups, because they don't want to feel like they are not loved there. So I think that's why. But we think also they try to socialize. Yes, that's it. Thank you.
You haven't answered my second question. So what kind of activity or what kind of things that you can do to invite them to join you? For example, if they're studying in Denpasar, for example, in Udayana, for example, I think you've seen a lot of Papuans also studying in Udayana, yeah? So how they, you know, interact with the other peoples in Bali, for example, or how can you, you know, invite them to, you know, like to mingle together, to join the same activity with us Indonesian, like in general, okay? What do you think?
Thank you for the question. And so I think that if we try to look Papuans like as our friend and not trying to make them feel that they are different from us, I think that is when we start a friendship with them. So it will also be like a bonding activity, a bonding situation for the rest of Indonesia and the Papuans, so that we can be friends with. So like if we already be friends with the Papuans, I believe Papuans and the rest of Indonesia in college or in any schools or college, we will get together really well. So I think that's
One last comment. I think we should also focus on the positive things about the interaction between Indonesian, yeah, because perhaps we are focusing more on the discriminations that we forgot to, you know, to spread the news about kindness. I mean, how we as an Indonesian live together, side by side, unity in diversity. I think we also should focus on that things, not just the discriminations. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Inung, for your questions. Maybe other judges want to give comment or ask the question for the second group.
We still have time?
Okay. Ms. Alfe or Ms. Yo?
All right, perhaps I want to ask one question, one short question. Guys, ladies, thank you very much for your presentation. It was awesome, yeah? So in your opinion, do you think that the government's effort already, make a difference regarding this issue? I mean, how they now they start to make a development, building infrastructures there. Does it make any difference, do you think?
Thank you for the question. I think seeing from, I think Jokowi's presidential actually have made a tremendous amount of progress in seeing how to, in developing Papua, but I think it can still be increased by a lot, seeing how they have contributed to our country. But I think in Jokowi's presidential, we've actually made like a very huge process, seeing how
the Papuans have you know, progress a lot than before. So
than before, yeah. Thank you.
So we have already tried something, yeah?
Yeah, we've tried something.
The society also can, do start to do the same also, yeah. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you so much, Ms. Alfe, and the second group for your presentation and answer. Now we are going to the next group presentation. It is from Saint Louis Satu Surabaya. With the title Justice for Indonesia's Human Rights. For Saint Louis Satu Surabaya. Saint Louis Satu Surabaya, are you here?
Yes, we're here.
Okay, the time is yours. Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Gabrielle Annette, and I'm here with my partner, Rebecca Chris. We are from Saint Louis Senior High School, Surabaya. First of all, we would like to thank the judges for this opportunity to present our essay called Justice for Indonesia's Human Rights. Next. These are the topics that we are going to talk about today. Speaking of today, it has been so hot here in Surabaya. And what do you crave on such a hot day?
Drinking ice.
Is there any problem with the connection?
Yes, my partner has some connection difficulty.
Maybe Gabriel can take over.
Hello.
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 Hello. We can hear you, Rebecca. Okay.
One of my favorite and cheapest ice cream is from the brand Ice, which has been at its peak these last 4 years. In 2017, they received awards such as Jawara Halal Award 2017 for the Best Newcomer Halal Products and Excellent Brand Award 2017. But behind this pride and awards, we noticed from some articles that ICE wasn't treating their workers right. As you can see in the picture, this was one of the examples that we found interesting. Can you believe that this food, which 90% of it is rice and the other 10% are vegetables, is worth 15,000 rupiahs? I'm pretty sure that they will starve throughout the day. For working with a not-so-high payment, this is not what they deserve. Notice something missing here? Human rights. Next.
In general, human rights are moral principles or norms that describe certain standards of human behavior and are regularly protected. According to Indonesia's Constitution Law No. 39 of 1999, human rights are a set of rights inherent in the nature and existence of man as a creature of the Almighty God that must be respected and protected by everyone. Human rights are important regardless of their race, sex, age, nationality, ethnicity, religion, and any other status a person holds. They've been attached to us since the day we were born and can't be separated from us. Human rights functioned as protection for us physically and mentally, allowing us to obtain more chances of receiving higher education and equal work opportunities. Without human rights, our lives will be controlled by the government and we will no longer have protection against society. It will cause a rise in cases of rape, discrimination, bullying, which might lead to depression and suicide, child labor, child exploitation, and other harassments. Next.
Do you recognize these people? These were the two famous political activists, Wijin Tukul and Marsina, back in Soeharto's era. On the left is Wijin Tukul. He was a famous poet back then. His poem was to criticize the government and to give people the courage to speak up. Unfortunately, on the 27th July 1998, he was found missing, and to this day, he is nowhere to be found. On the right, we have Marsina. She was so brave that she held a protest to raise wages on 2nd May 1993. 3 days later, she went missing and was found dead on 8th May 1993. The head of the forensic department that handled Marsina's case said that she was abused till death. In Soeharto's era, missing political activists was a usual thing. Some were found dead, but some remained a mystery. People were trying to fight and speak up for their opinions in fear. Finally, in 1998, after the downfall of Soeharto's era, Law No. 9 of 1998 about freedom of speech was born. People nowadays can express their opinion through protest, but some also mistreated this opportunity by vandalizing, looting, and spreading hoax. Next.
Gender equality is also a huge issue. For example, classic Indonesian stereotype where women have to stay in the kitchen, take care of the kids, and serve her husband while he works and chases his career. Not to mention that they still think that men will always be above women, which annoys me because, okay, maybe some men reconsider that stereotype and treat women equally, but some of them don't and they cause fear to women. For example, it's never safe for a woman to walk alone because they will most likely get catcalled. Even sometimes I get catcalled in my neighborhood and it's super uncomfortable and makes me scared because who knows what they will do next. Luckily, I got out safe, but some women weren't as lucky as I was. Next. Cases like rape, marital rape, sexual harassment, and domestic violence against women kept increasing throughout the years. In 2016, total reported cases were around 200,000. This data wasn't all of the cases, considering a lot of women were afraid to speak up. Then, around 406,178 cases were reported in 2018, but not all of them were handled by the government. Some were neglected, some accused the victim, and some didn't want to speak up about it because the rapist might have threatened them. The government did produce the Elimination of Sexual Violence Bill, or known as RUU PKS, to protect women, but till now it's still uncertain because they said it was somewhat difficult to discuss. Next.
Human rights and equality must be applied by everyone and to everyone, even kids. Cases like bullying between kids can give negative outcomes, including impacts on mental health. Victims can experience negative physical, social, emotional, academic, and mental health issues. An elementary student with the initial RS in Central Java was bullied for 2 years. He was physically bullied back in fourth grade because he couldn't afford a new school clock that he accidentally broke while he was playing soccer. His character had changed. He often shot himself and he didn't want to go to school anymore. His parents were worried about his mental health. They then brought him to a psychiatrist and confirmed that RS had depression. The worst thing about this case is that RS had no one to rely on. His parents didn't understand what depression was and couldn't afford a psychiatrist. His school didn't even bother about this case. His father once informed this to his school, but he got rejected and kicked out. The school's principal said, "Sorry, there's no such thing as bullying. This is a regular occurrence of rowdy between students." Luckily, in October 2019, the Grobogan Regency of Child Protection invited RS and their parents to their office. They gave RS free medication, and now RS is in a much better condition and he's back to school. Next. Not only kids, but the social status between regular citizens and lawmakers are sometimes unfair. In most cases, it seems like lawmakers have more privilege. Lawmakers usually get lighter penalties, even in severe cases. Imam Nahrawi, ex-minister of Youth and Sport, was caught corrupting on grant funds for a total of 8.3 billion rupiahs. Based on CNN Indonesia's article, he was sentenced to 7 years in prison and 400 million rupiah fine. Meanwhile, Andi Syaputra, a 30-year-old citizen that was sentenced to 7 years in prison, for stealing 11 to 14 kilograms of banana worth around 150,000 rupees. Since when? Corrupting 8.2 billions of grant fund has the same penalty as stealing 150,000 rupees worth of banana. Next.
Now we know that laws can't always fully protect us. We mustn't stay quiet. Don't be afraid to speak up for yourself about what makes you feel uncomfortable. Also, educate yourself and others to protect. Consider other people's rights and treat them how you want them to treat you. Always remember that we are all equal. Next.
Thank you for listening to our presentation. Any questions?
Okay, thank you for the first group's presentation. Now is the Q&A and discussion session with the judges. Maybe Ms. Johanna wants to go first.
Okay, so thank you, Amel. Okay, so thank you, group four, yeah, from SMA St. Louis, Surabaya. So I really appreciate your PowerPoint slides. Yeah, are very well prepared there, so we can easily comprehend what you are talking about by watching or by looking at your PowerPoint slide. Anyway, I have a kind of further questions related to the case that you have mentioned in ICE company. Yeah.
Yes.
Could you please explain further why the underpayment given by the company belongs to the violating human rights? Did you get my point?
Yes.
Okay.
Give us a moment.
Mm-hmm. Because they were underpaid, but they were overworked. I saw from some articles that there is this woman that was pregnant, but she has to work till 10 a.m. I think.
Oh, really?
And that was Yes, and it was unfair. And I saw from some articles that they don't have the insurance, health insurance, the BPJS. So the ammonia on the factory is high. So they were contaminated and they can't pay for their health because they were underpaid and they don't have insurance. That's why I think it was so violating for the human right.
Okay. Have you tried to look for the information related to Undang-Undang Ketenagakerjaan related to that?
Yeah.
And what is violating Undang-Undang Ketenagakerjaan? In what points?
Rebecca.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, please.
Maybe Rebecca has connection issue.
Okay, I have the answer.
Okay. Yes, please.
Okay, from the article, they violate the Tenaga Kerja dan Transmigrasi nomor 232 tahun 2003 di ayat 1 pasal 6.
Could you please mention it?
Jelaskan mogok kerja yang dilakukan secara tidak sah dikualifikasikan sebagai mangkir. And then di ayat 2 menyatakan pemanggilan untuk kembali kerja bagi pelaku mogok dilakukan oleh pengusaha. Wait. Wait. Oh ya, okay. So pada terus kemudian, and then pada ayat 3 dijelaskan pekerja atau buruh yang tidak memenuhi panggilan maka dianggap mengundurkan diri. So the situation was about a lot of ICE workers that got that got fired.
Okay. Gabriel okay. And Rebecca's, thank you for your answer. Maybe Miss Yu, is enough or not?
Yeah. I think first of all, before you, my suggestion, yeah, before you try to connect this case with human rights, it's better for you to relate it with Undang-Undang Ketenagakerjaan first. Yeah, I think. Yeah. Okay. So thank you very much.
Miss Johanna for the question. Now we are going to the fifth groups from SMA Negeri 1 Sumpiu Banyumas with the title Framing Indonesian Human Rights in a Perspective of Plural Society. For SMA Negeri 1 Sumpiu Banyumas, are you here?
Yes, I am here.
Okay.
Yes, here.
Okay, time is yours. Thank you.
Hey, framing Indonesian human rights in a perspective of plural society. Next. Hello, I am Eliona Navanes and with my friend Salsa Bilanadipa Kuroman. We are from Senior High School 1 Sumpiu Banyumas Central Java. Today, we are here. We will participate in a final of essay competition. Next. Indonesia is a country that rich with custom, religion, language, and many more. In Indonesia society, social diversity is very much. We are born to have rights and that are all equal. We are free to express and show who we are. Because Indonesia is rich with diversity, so Indonesia called a plural country. Plurality is a condition where many difference. So we can look that the picture number one is cultures in Indonesia. For example, reog in Ponorogo, kecak dance in Bali, traditional dance, and many more. In picture two, we can look that the picture is religion in Indonesia, such as Islam, Christianity, Catholic, Hinduism, Buddhist, and Confucianism. In picture three, we can look at the tribes in Indonesia. For example, Javanese, Madurese, Sundanese, and many more. Okay, next. Diversity in a society cannot be separated from human rights. Human rights is a legal and normative concept, which states that every human being has inherent rights. Human rights is applies to any time, anywhere, and to anyone. Human rights has been owned since we are born. Some people think that with human rights, we freedom to do anything. That is true, but the freedom is not really free either. This freedom is limited by human rights that people own. Rights always coexist with obligations. We are have human rights to declare, but also we have the obligation to listen people's opinions. Many people want their human rights be fulfilled and want to achieve. However, they forgot to do the obligation with each people. Okay, next. The difference creates social conflict. The difference in people's lives are very diverse. The difference opinion between the community group that create social conflict between them. Social conflict occur using difference as a reason to start it. Social conflict occurs on small or large scale. Usually, social conflict occurs is small and easy to resolve, but also social conflict or injuries and displacement. This conflict does not rule out a violation of human rights that can occur in people's lives. For example, in Indonesia, in the Papua, there was a shooting incident by an armed criminal group against an employee of the company. The case in Papua was sparked by a dispute. Social conflict do not occur in Indonesia alone, but also in other countries. Recently, in the United States of America, was a murder of black citizen who was beaten by a white of policeman. The case in the United States is caused by racial difference. Social conflict occurred is caused by human who do not to tolerance, who do not to understand with difference each people, and who do not to respect with other people. Thank you.
Next.
Okay, next.
Okay, quote from the official website of the Ministry of Education and Culture of Indonesia. The problems that arise in the diversity of society are, first, the emergency of conflicts between cultures. The life of the Indonesian nation, which is of various ethnicities, customs, religious, cultures, and others, is sometimes colored by conflict between cultures. This is evident from the emergency of racial conflict. Second, social jealousy. Example of conflict in Indonesia due to social jealousy are, one, the Tasikmalaya incident caused by social jealousy between the indigenous people and the Chinese community. Two, Poso incident because the religious differences between Muslim and Christians. Three, the Sambas incident caused by ethnic differences between Dayak as indigenous and Maduras as immigrant tribes. Four, Aceh and Papua caused by differences in political interests. Third, regional sentiment. For example, social damage that occurred in Jakarta between the Betawi as native and Madures as immigrant. The last changes in cultural values due to globalization. It has actually triggered the emergency of social cultural conflict in Indonesia. Next. In order for diversity in society not to become a factor causing clash and split that lead to conflict, tolerance and mutual respect are required. As part of diversity, we must be able to accept differences and not struggle to equalize them. But the differences that exist make us realize that we must be united and together, no longer limited by choice, group, race, ethnicity, religion, but as one, Republic Indonesia. Next. The diversity of society in the framework of Bhinneka Tunggal Ika has important meanings, namely as follows. Diversity is not an element of division, but instead creates national unity through motto of Bhinneka Tunggal Ika. Next. Because everyone has the right to be treated fairly and equally in the public spaces, from simple thing to more complex thing. The point is that there is no oppression for everyone to release their expression and aspiration. Next. Okay, I think enough from us. Thanks a lot, all. There are any question?
All right. Thank you so much for SMA Negeri 1 Sempiu Banyumas for your presentation. Next is the Q&A and discussion session with our judges. Maybe Miss Alve or Miss Inu to give the comments.
Okay. I'd like to ask questions to group five. Yeah, first I'd like to appreciate you for creating the PowerPoints and your nice presentations. I'd like to ask you as students, so what do you do to raise awareness of this, diversities of Indonesia in terms of awareness that every single citizen in Indonesia has the equal rights? So as a student, how do you raise those awareness?
Okay, I think equally in the to tolerance with other about difference, because in Indonesia diversity is very much with the first. Okay.
You mentioned tolerance. Tolerance, right? Eleonai. Yeah, you mentioned tolerance. Okay, Salsa Bila, what do you think? Do you get my questions?
I'm sorry, could you repeat your question,
okay,
please?
Okay, yes, as students, so you raised these topics of human rights in Indonesia, because Indonesia's diverse nations, yeah? So as a student, how do you raise awareness of the equality within human rights in a multi cultural diversity and multi religions diversity here? As a student, how do you start having that kind of awareness? And for you to be able to treat others equally. Do you get my question, Sasabila? Hello? Sasa?
Okay, Sasa Bila, did you get the point from Ms. Inu question?
I think she has an issue.
Oh, okay.
Connection issue. Okay.
Okay.
Anyway.
Okay, maybe...
okay, I'll answer.
Okay. Here. Sansa, if you have any connection problem, you can turn off your camera and then just answer it in the audio.
Oh, okay. Sansa,
she's gone.
Okay. Maybe Eliona wants to ask
your
question.
Sorry.
Oh, she's back.
Okay. I'm sorry. Being a student, we should not difference, jadi nggak beda-bedain gitu loh. Like we should be accompany all friends, not make a difference about us like that. That's from me.
Okay, thank you.
Maybe Ms. Inu wants to give another comment, or is enough to the session?
I think that's all from me, Mamel. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Miss Inung. Okay, Miss Alfe, maybe wants to give comment or maybe ask the question.
Okay, thank you, Amel, for the time. Hi, Eliona and Salsabila. So I have actually one short question. So you mentioned your essay that the diversity at some point will be a great social concept to build an advanced and prosperous Indonesian nation. Can you elaborate more on that point? How the diversity bring prosper for our nation?
Okay, I think with the slogan Bhinneka Tunggal Ika, so that not to curse it by social conflict in the plural society.
Okay. From Eleni. Okay, because many human rights violations in the Indonesia are caused by difference or diversity, we will explain that which human rights violation are chosen through the Bhinneka Tunggal Ika. Bhinneka Tunggal Ika will be accommodate us like that. Can you catch what I'm
like that?
Thank you so much for the brief group and also our judges for the question. Now we are going to the next group. It is from SMA Negeri Satu Denpasar with the title Equalizing Human Rights Through Multicultural Education in the Millennial Era for Advanced Indonesia in 2030. For SMA Negeri Satu Denpasar, are you here?
Especially yes.
Okay, the time is yours. Thank you.
Yes, thank you. Hi, everyone. So, good morning to all of the audience, good morning to the honorable judges, and good morning to all of the committees. So now we are here for joining the competition, essay competition 2020. So before we present our presentation, let us introduce ourselves. So my name is Made Melda Putri Nereswari, and I am as the team leader, and these are my teammates.
My name is Made Rania Kalista Suhadi, and you can call me Rania.
And my name is Dayutia Putri Adnyani. You can call me Dayutia.
So today we will present our essay, and as you can see, this is our mind map. The past Friday, first,
next.
Introduction, body, and the last is conclusion. So the title of our essay is
Equalizing Human Rights Through Multicultural Education in the Millennial Era for Advanced Indonesia in 2030.
Next. So now I'm going to explain about human rights in general. Human rights belongs to everyone without any kinds of discrimination about culture, ethnic, religion, and gender, since it's universal. According to Pancasila, human rights are applied liberally, but it's restricted by other human rights. However, in reality, the society haven't really implemented it yet. So the next one is about science and technology. I'm sure you guys are familiar with technology, right? Okay, I will explain about that. The rapid development of science and technology is a transition and globalization process that affect our education. This development must be based on moral and humanity in order to equalize the use of it.
And the next one is, you guys heard that Indonesia is an archipelago state, right? Indonesia has a plentiful island inside of it. As stated in the 1945 Constitution of Republic of Indonesia, paragraph 32, clause 1, the state advances Indonesia's national culture in the midst of civilization by guaranteeing the freedom of society in maintaining and developing its
cultural values. This is why we need multicultural education to teach us how to respect and appreciate our differences. And so next.
Now, we are going to explain the body section and we will explain it even more. So the first one, I will explain about zoning system in Indonesia. Firstly, the application of zoning system in Indonesia causing limited rights on this multicultural educational system. It makes students feel strange toward our culture diversity and also complicates them to learn other culture. Because the system restricts students who are outside the area to get into the school that they want. It makes the gap between educational style in Indonesia still massive. Hence, multicultural education can be used as a conductor and it will bring up mutual acceptance of each other. So guys, as you can see on the screen, here's the website that government used to register school using PPDB.
Next. Okay. So secondly, science and technology is the main basis of information stores in big cities, and it can be a solution towards the lack of teachers by doing e-learning or some online learning. We just need appealing materials to make students interested in the materials and will make students study even more. But another case with the rural areas, as you guys can see in this on the screen, that is Badui tribe, which is, for example, Badui tribe. They have a tradition not to receive any formal education or technology because they claim that it is against their culture. And they think that maintaining their tradition is more important than getting to know their outside of their world. The government once tried to provide them with formal education to the children there, but they refused to take it. And from the arguments above, you can see that the implementation of human rights in Indonesia is not really equal yet because we haven't really implemented multicultural education. And tolerance is one of the results of multicultural education that makes students feel more familiar with our differences. And this is also can be a stepping point to actualize the mission of Indonesia's government in 2030 in making our high quality education and will be approved by other countries. Next.
Steps that can be taken to actualize human rights through multicultural education with science technology. Next. Is for example creating organization that focusing in the education field in social media. Meanwhile, for the rural areas, we can interest several people from the organization to its multicultural education to the student there. We can also do feasible activities such as student exchange. So the lack of the technology in rural areas is not a big obstacle to implement multicultural education.
Next. So to sum that all up to all of the arguments above, with Indonesia's diversity, we require multicultural education because we think that it is really, really effective for Indonesia's future. And moreover, with the support of science and technology, we can actually actualize Advance Indonesia in 2030. And there is so many ways to actually equalize human rights and specifically in the education field. Next.
Okay, thank you. That's all about our presentation. We're sorry if we're making any mistakes. If you have a question, you can ask us.
All right, thank you so much for SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar. Actually, you still have 2 minutes. Maybe, is there anything you want to say about your topic?
Yes, that's all about our presentation.
Okay. Okay, so we are going to the Q&A and discussion session with our judges. Maybe who wants to go first to give
a comment? Okay. Hi, Amel. I want to go first. Okay. Hi, everyone. You are the second group from SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar, ya?
Yes.
Okay, I'd like to ask you, you mentioned about multicultural educations, and then you mentioned about the zoning system. I actually would like you to elaborate more how the zoning system influences the understanding of the other culture. I mean, it gives a negative effect on understanding other culture. How so, the zoning system? Because I believe it applies in provinces, right? So how it affect the multicultural education? Can you elaborate more on that?
Lanjutannya yang ini ya.
So thank you for your question. I will try my best to answer your question. So we think that the zoning system is restricted the students' right to choose what school that they want, maybe in the other provinces. They can go to that school because of the zoning system.
Yeah. And the positive effects about zoning system are weigh out the stigma about favorite school, therefore the student composition will be more heterogeneous, so it will make a healthy competition among the students.
I believe there is a certain amount of percentage, yeah, that people coming from different regional area or even from different provinces can go to a particular schools, right?
Yes.
There are still percentage. But, so it means that it doesn't close the opportunity for students from different, you know, different cultural background to, go.
It's just a small percentage that they... Because they are restricted to, they restricted their rights to get the school that they want.
Okay, thank you for your answer.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
All right, thank you, Ms. Ino, for your question. Maybe we still have about 3 minutes in the Q&A session. Ms. Alfe or Ms. Johanna?
Can I?
Okay,
so thank you, Group 6 from SMA Negeri 1 Denpasar for very clear explanation. Okay, I would like to clarify on what you have said in your paper related to one of the ways to actualize the equal rights is by having multicultural education and doing feasible activities in your society. So I would like to know more about the feasible activities in society that happens in your surrounding, particularly in Bali. So what do you already have there? Yeah, to increase the multicultural education. Thank you.
Thank you for your question. Mm-hmm. And we will try my best. We will try our best to answer your question. So particularly in Bali, we don't really have the feasible activities or the organization, but as we see on TV, we know that an organization that focusing on multicultural education, and that is eCompass. It's a family organization that they want to unite all of the cultural differences in Indonesia. And they are coming from a family that were the parents that were the victim of Bali bombing. Mm-hmm. And they want to use that their child's inheritance to make an organization about multicultural education in Indonesia. But we don't really have that organization in Bali yet.
Mm-hmm.
But we see on TV.
Okay, yeah, thank you. Anyway, do you, I mean you three, do you have any idea Yeah, because you said that there's no kind of visible activities in Bali. So do you have any idea to start a kind of visible activity? Maybe from the very simple one in your school, maybe, or in your neighborhood, maybe.
Maybe they are still discussing.
Okay, thank you for your question again, and we will try my best to answer your question. So what we think is we think that we want to make maybe an organization that have some events about multicultural education. Maybe we can explore it on social media, and we will share about multicultural education more, and maybe we will go to maybe to the isolated areas to maybe to teach them about how and what is multicultural education, and maybe that will make a chemistry between the cities area and the rural areas.
Okay, so thank you. Hope you can really realize your idea. I think it's a great idea so that you can make changes in your society.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
All right, thank you so much for the 6 group presentation and answer for the judges' question. Now we are going to the next presentation from SMA Negeri 1 Jember with the title Edu Changing: A Gateway Movement of Gender Stereotypes on Education in Indonesia. For SMA Negeri 1 Jember, are you here?
Yes, we are here.
Okay, the time is yours. Thank you.
Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So, good morning, everyone. First of all, we're sorry that we can't use the background because our surrounding is not compatible. We will introduce ourselves. My name is Akila Sakanti.
And I'm Gevira Alma.
And we came from SMA Negeri 1 Jember as the 7th performer. Right now, we will present you our presentation about EduChanging, which is a gateway movement of gender stereotypes on education in Indonesia.
Okay, to the next slide, please. Yes, could you play the video?
Thank you in advance. I don't wanna dance. I don't need your hands all over me. If I want a man, then I'ma get a man. But it's never my priority. I was in my zone before you came along. Don't want you to take this personal. Blah, blah, blah. I be like, nah, to the high, to the no, no, no. All my ladies, listen up. If that boy ain't giving up.
Okay, so from the video, we can know that there was a daughter who was going to apply for a master's degree in one of the most prestigious universities in the world, which is Oxford, but her mom stopped her because her mom had like some kind of an understanding that women should be good at doing chores. They don't need like a high education because their role are just going to be a complement of their husbands, like support their husbands doing all the chores because their husband are going to be busy working. Well, the reason why we served you all this video is because we want to portray one of the most important issue in our daily life, which is education and how our society reacts to it. So the community still manages to put women under men and domesticate them, including in the realm of their education. Well, Japanese culture even has a term for this, which is called as konjo winking, which we thought that it is like the root of why there are like gender stereotypes going around us. So this Japanese term leads to the came up of gender stereotype, which defy the rules of women and men. So women education only exists as a form of formality, so they should be married at a young age, giving birth, taking care of their kids, while men are always expected to be high educated and required to work hard for a living of their family. And unfortunately, the stereotypes going around the community are the opposite of the human rights and also the law in Indonesia.
So, as for what has been stated in the 1945 Constitution of the Republic of Indonesia, Section 9 about education and culture, Article 31.3, which sounds like the government organizes and implements a national education system to be regulated by law that aims at enhancing and people's feelings as well as moral excellence to upgrade national life. It is clear that it mandates every citizen to have the right to equal education. To be more specific, there is no border between men and women. To be focused on education for women, in Law Number 39 of 1999, Article 48, which sounds like women have the right to education and their mind at all types, levels, and paths of education, following the requirements that have been determined. Based on both of these laws, it is clear that our government allows either women or men to have the highest stage of education. But as we have seen in reality, women are being underestimated to have a higher education. This is why we created a movement called Next Please.
Thank you in advance. I don't.
Edit changing. So our main goal is to help young generation, especially women, on breaking out of the community stereotypes so they can run to their dreams without any obstacle. We also hope this well-spread information of this movement can also contribute on changing older generation's way of thinking.
Okay, to the next slide, please. So edit changing consists of three steps, which the first one is educate. So as the first step of this movement, educate has a role on spreading out anything that women would need to defend themselves from the gender stereotypes. This step provides information about the importance of high education in women. One of the examples is that educating women has proven to produce many additional socioeconomic gains that benefit entire societies. This kind of information can be used by women on fighting for their rights of education in front of other people who believe in gender stereotypes. This tab will also provide the information about ways to prevent future continuation of these stereotypes. Mm-hmm. For example, parents need to give their kids natural games and toys and treat boys and girls in the same way. Well, to the next slide, please. The next step, which brings us closer to our goal, is change. This step is all about encouraging people, especially women, to bravely step out of gender stereotypes by implementing all the information that they have got from the previous step, which is educate. This implementation are expected to make this movement spread well to the community, so cutting off the stereotypes will be effective and efficient. And this step can also help women gathering out their powers on fighting against how the community expected them to be. And once this step is done, women are going to move to the next step. Can you go to the next slide, please? The next step is winning. So to win against the gender stereotypes is our main goal, right? If women have been doing all the previous steps, it indicates that they're winners because they've been trying to change how the community thinks. There must be some part of the community. They're going to grow wiser and realize the importance of education quality.
To the next slide, please. So promoting edu-changing is essential in order to spread this movement to the society equally and widely. Instagram and Twitter are the social media that we choose because of their popularity. Based on Statista, there are 77.9 million users of Instagram in the ages of 18 to 24 years old, and Twitter users is projected to reach 22.8 million users of Indonesians. We believe that these two social media can help us to rise up our hashtag and popularize our movement so that people will know and they can also educate themselves. Later on, we will divide our social media page into three sections that we have as our main topic, which is educate, change, and winning, that we can see on the right side of the slide. And then our important agenda is winning. And is also performing a live Instagram session periodically with successful women in Indonesia that reach their dreams by prioritizing their goals in education without minding the stereotypes that used to hold them back. Okay, so this conclusion is gender stereotypes need to be removed because they have been proven to be irrelevant. One of the solutions that we can implement is edu-changing, because edu-changing is created with a hope to gradually raise society's awareness in education. Equality also eliminates gender stereotypes of the community. Educate, as the first step of this movement, has a role on spreading out information about the importance of higher education in women, such as educating women to produce many additional socioeconomic gains that benefit entire societies. Change is about encouraging women to briefly step out of gender stereotypes by spreading the information well to the community. And the last step, we have winning, which is to win against the gender stereotypes. Okay, we think that is all our presentation.
Thank you.
Is there any questions?
Thank you so much for the seventh group from SMA Negeri 1 Jember. You put a TikTok video on your presentation as well, yeah? Yeah, that's great. So maybe we are moving to the Q&A and discussion session with our judges. Okay, so who wants to go first? Miss Alfie? Or Miss Alfie or Miss Johanna?
Okay, I can go first. Okay, yeah. So thank you Group 7 from SMA Negeri 1 Jember, yeah. Okay, so I really appreciate your creativity in delivering the presentation, like Amel just said before, using TikTok as illustrations. I think it's good. Yeah, okay, well, I'm curious about the edu changing, yeah, a kind of program. Is it a program that you design yourself by your group?
Oh yes, so movement. Yes, this movement is actually, you know, that there are a lot of people out there who has like the same aspiration as with us. Mm-hmm. But we originally designed this because we want to make like a social media or a platform for people to find like a well-organized information about
how to change people's perspective before.
Yes. So like the importance of education, mm-hmm. and how women should, prioritize their education, prioritize their goal. We wanted to make a like well-organized platform. So if someone want to find like, what is the importance of education, just go find our Instagram, then they can find it. That is our main goal, have a well-organized social media to change how the society thinks.
Is the social media, I mean, for example, Instagram that you mentioned before, already exist now?
Oh, it hasn't exist yet, okay. But in our presentation, we have like a pretty much how our Instagram would look like in the last slide, before
and
the last
slide,
yeah.
Okay, because honestly, yesterday I tried to search on the Instagram to look for that movement that you have written down in your paper, and then I tried to use the hashtag edu-changing, but
yes.
There I only can find 3 feeds from other people from other countries, which is not yours. So I'm curious whether the movement that you have written down is already exists or not, yeah, in case I miss that one. So I clarify it today that actually it is not it doesn't exist yet now.
We really hope to really implement it like someday.
Okay. yeah so I'm really waiting for that results, yeah, that realization. Maybe later you can mention extension 2020 in your feeds, maybe, yeah, so can all the committees and me and the other judges also can check whether you really implement it or not, yeah. Okay, well, anyway, it is a kind of good idea, yeah, to have edu changing. You have education changing and winning. Sorry, what are those three? Yeah, winning. Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Uh-huh. So my last question is related to the last aspect, which is winning.
Yes.
So how can you assess? Yeah. How can you say whether this movement is successful or not? How can you know that the people or the follower win the movement? I mean, win or meet the objectives that you have set before. By how? I mean, how do you assess it?
Okay, so thank you for the question. I'll try to answer this. So in winning in our social media, it is like, as we said before, it is full of, what is that? Like
achievements that our followers have gained before by receiving information from our Instagram, Twitter, and etc. So we need to appreciate them. So this is why we create winning, which is filled with achievements.
Their stories. Yes.
That we're focused on educations, actually.
Yeah, so maybe we can like open our DM like openly wide for everyone. So
if everyone can share it.
So if like so if they get something from us, like from the section of educate, I mean, like, they can tell the stories to us through our DM, and we are going to share that stories in the section of winning. So, yeah, that's just how we, like, indicate that we are winners. Like, they really implement all the steps, and they succeed. So, that's pretty much how it is going.
Okay, I see. Uh-huh. So, you can say that they win for themselves by, what is it? They implement all of the steps that you give, and then they are really educated related to this gender stereotype, not to have the similar point of view anymore. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I see. Uh-huh. So thank you. So once again, I really wait for the Instagram that you are promising us now. Yeah. Okay. Don't forget to mention extension 2020. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Maybe I can have time. Yeah, I can. I'd like to comment on these groups. Actually, it's a very good topic that you are taking now about the woman empowerment. Yeah, in education especially. Is that what you mean, right? Mm-hmm. So, if you have this goal and then you really want to make this movement, right? And what I suggest you is that you can cooperate with the organization that already exists. Maybe you can make a bigger platform, not just two of you, but also, you know, like, I believe that there are organizations in Indonesia already about this, you know, women education empowerment that already exists that has the same goal as you. So you can make it bigger, and then you can make it you know, like winning, like all together Indonesian women, not just you. Okay, right. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much. It will really help. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much for the seventh group presentation and answer, and also our judges, Miss Johanna and Miss Inung, for the question and suggestion. Yeah. Okay, everyone, we have now come to the last group presentation. It is from SMA Negeri 1 Srono Banyuwangi with the title Study of Human Rights Influence in Discrimination Cases in Building Community Welfare. Okay, so SMA Negeri 1 Srono Banyuwangi, are you here?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, so the time is yours. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. How are you today? I hope all of you have a great day today. We're from Senior High School, Wansrono. My name is Nevira Maharani, and my friends.
I am Kri Nurul Aziza.
My name is Sesti Pramesti.
Here, we will present about the human study of human rights, influence, and discrimination cases in building community welfare. Next. Human rights exist in every human being as a gift from Almighty. Human rights are applied whenever, wherever, and for anyone universally. Human rights are inherent in human by born and cannot be revoked. Next. human rights goals. Therefore, the Indonesia has already regulation in human rights. It is IMAR preventing violence, developing respect, encouraging continuous responsible action, and as well as maintaining ordinary life. These ordinary lives encourage the welfare of the community. It is also necessary so that the human will act arbitrarily to other human. That human rights are an important concept in human life. Next. Concept of equality in diversity. The concept of equality is the most important view in upholding human rights in the surrounding environment. Equality means no special environment for anyone. Every person is placed on the same level without being differentiated. This is confirmed in Article 7 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which reads, all people are equal before the law and are entitled to equal protection of the law without discrimination. They have the right to equal protection against any form of discrimination contrary to this declaration and against any incitement to show discrimination. Next. Then, how does the enforcement of human rights encourage community welfare? Human rights enforcement in Indonesia is still minimal. At least 51 human rights violations were recorded at 2019. Okay, it is a huge duty to create an environment where people wear respect to their of other. Some people don't understand human obligation and rights. Many of them are not indifferent to their obligation, but they want their right is being fulfilled. In fact, rights are consequences that are obtained obligation after being fulfilled or not. They don't understand how to respond to diversity, not in a selfish way of getting personal pleasure, but on the contrary, hit the other in order to get welfare equally. Reporting from occasion.com, the Human Rights Day Coalition or Peringatan Koalisi Hari HAM record at least 51 human rights violations that occurred at 2019 and have not been resolved by the government. It saw that the enforcement of human rights in Indonesia is still minimal. Human rights violations that are often carried out by several groups, namely discrimination that results in disturbing the welfare of the community. Next. The problems. Okay, discrimination of BPJS Kesehatan members who have got with different payment levels is violating the law on human rights article 28H paragraph 1. You can see the latest cost data on the screen from BPJS Kesehatan. Okay. Patient member of the Health Social Security Administration or BPJS Kesehatan got several different treatment and facility in each class. The patient complained because he didn't got thorough treatment. For example, when a third grade patient needs urgent service, however, those who got the faster service are the first grade patient. Even though the condition of the third grade patient is more serious to be handled. This quote happened because the cost card to first class patient was 59,500 rupiah, and mid 2016, the contribution rate was increased to 80,000 rupiah per month. Meanwhile, the fee charged to third grade patient only 25,500 rupiah. This showed that the discrimination occurred in BPJS Kesehatan member was caused by the difference monthly bill. Of course, this affects the welfare of society and is not in accordance with Article 28H, paragraph 1. This Article 28H, paragraph 1 read, the right to live in physical and spiritual prosperity, to have a place to live, and to have a good and healthy living environment, the right to obtain health service. Next.
LPG gas distribution. The distribution of 3 kg LPG gas cylinders for poor people. Manuel, for the middle class and above, 12 kg LPG cylinders provided. All people get the same facilities. However, the enforcement and social blessing that operate in Indonesia, it turns out that there is human rights enforcement conducted to improve the welfare of its people. For example, distribution of 3 kg LPG gas cylinders are only attended for people who really cannot afford pay it in an affordable price. Then, for the middle and high class, 12 kg LPG gas cylinders is also provided. So, the bottom level community has the same chance and as the middle to upper class society without being burdened by causes. Next. Completion efforts. Prioritizing first serving for people who need first serving. The level on the BPJS card may be removed to support the welfare of the community. Efforts in the health sector like this, actually BPJS managers have to prioritize the people who need first service and emergency aids. The management person of the BPJS have to give priority for people who need quicker and emergency serving. An appropriate increase of the BPJS payment may be able to solve it. Then, all people get the same quality facilities without this distinguishing of level of the BPJS card. The serving for the all patient is the same. There is no more distinction to improve welfare in society. Next. Conclusion. Human rights is need to be upheld to avoid discrimination of more fatal human rights violations, because the enforcing human rights equality and diversity will be realized. It is also supported by the concept of equality. Human rights have to be conducted in Indonesian diversity. Even though among the discrimination cases, there are already some groups who respect the human rights of others. Strengthening human rights requires more attention. Not only discrimination will be more prevalent, but more serious human rights violation will also arise. This can occur due to the lack of public understanding of human rights. Diversity in Indonesia is indeed an obstacle of creating prosperity. If the people don't respect the right of others and apply the concept of equality on the other social life, will be orderly if civil society respect the others' right.
So that are from us. Thank you for attention. If we have a mistake, please forgive if I don't. Feel free to ask now. We will do my best to answer them. Thank you. Any question?
So. Alright. Thank you so much for SMA Negeri 1 Srono Banyuwangi's group, and also you are the last group ya for today's session. Now we are going the Q&A and discussion session with our judges. Maybe Miss Alfe wants to go first.
Okay, thank you, Amel. First of all, thank you, ladies, for your presentation about the human rights. Yeah. So you mentioned about, what is that? Most of the cases are from the government. So the discrimination, let's say, discrimination by the government, yeah, to its public. So how do you think our government will start to fix this kind of thing? So the steps that you suggest to our government.
All right, maybe they still discuss. Right.
Did you guys get my question?
Yes, I answered the question. Okay, the government must pay more attention to community problems than yes.
Wait a minute.
Okay, there must be a further police of discrimination case.
Okay, maybe you can discuss with your group first, yeah, to answer the question.
Jadi pemerintah harus lebih mengedepankan kepentingan umum ya, agar tidak ada diskriminasi lagi. Jadi perlu adanya mungkin
mungkin jadi seperti ini, untuk pembayarannya itu kan ada kelas-kelasnya. Nah itu gimana kalau sampamanya itu diratakan gitu, jadi antara kelas 1, 2, 3 itu disamakan semuanya gitu, kalau bisa. Soalnya kan kita juga nggak tahu nanti seorang pasien itu nanti itu membutuhkan pertolongan yang benar-benar, apa ya?
Benar-benar darurat.
Iya, benar-benar darurat banget gitu. Jadi utamakan dulu
pasien yang benar-benar memerlukan terlebih dahulu.
Okay, thank you very much for the answer.
Ms. Alpe, it is enough or you want to ask another question?
I think that's all from me. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Alpe. Mungkin for Ms. and Ms. Inung and Ms. Hey.
I think I have a question for these groups. In your opinion, I'd like to ask your opinion about what is, in your opinion, what is the relation between privileges and human rights?
Wait.
Yeah, privileges and human rights. And how does it go side by side in your opinion?
Okay, did you get the point?
Yes, still discussion.
You can answer the question from now.
Jadi sesuai kebutuhan, jika saja
Okay, so maybe you want to discuss with your group first. Okay. Did you get the points from the Ms. Alpe question or not? Maybe if you didn't get
yes, we got the point.
Okay. Inung, Ms. Inung, sorry, Ms. Inung, question.
Jadi tetap ya sesuai kebutuhan, jika saja pelayanan bagaimana ya, si pasien itu kan pasti ada yang kondisinya kondisi yang lebih kritis. Membutuhkan kritis dengan kondisi yang mungkin kurang
ya, dia sakit tetapi itu apa, jika kita apa utamakan, lebih mengutamakan yang sangat-sangat kritis banget gitu.
Ya, jadi
ya kita tahu kalau orang yang pergi ke rumah sakit itu mesti membutuhkan
penanganan,
tapi jika yang
is there anything else that you want to say for from the last group? Or it is enough?
That's okay. Thank you for your effort in answering my questions.
All right. Because the time is already up. Now we have, thank you so much for the last group, for your presentation and answer. And also our judges for the question and suggestion, yeah, and opinions.
Okay, everyone. Now we have now come to the end of today's events. On behalf of the of all the committee members, I would like to express my utmost gratitude to all the judges and all of the participants, especially for the essay competition participants on the second day of Extension 2020 event. All right, so we would like to thank all participants to participate this event. And I just want to remind you that the awarding will be announced today at 1 p.m. So or after break session, yeah. So please stay tuned for that because we would like to see who will be the winner from three categories of the competition. All right, everyone. Now is the break session. Please take your time as given. Don't forget to eat something to gain your energy back. And we will meet again at 1 p.m. I'm Amelia Golda, as your master of ceremony. From the deepest of my heart, I do apologize for my mistake in guiding this session. Once again, thank you very much for your attention. However, we will do a photo session before I end this session. Okay, so maybe everyone can turn on your camera. So, okay, is everyone ready? And I will come down for the session. Okay, now I will come down from 3, 2, 1. Smile. Okay, one more time. 3, 2, 1. Smile. All right, thank you so much, everyone. For all participants, you may leave the room. Thanks for your participation for this session. Once again, thank you and goodbye, everyone. See you at 1 p.m.